We're going to the fourth quarter. I'm Kurt Gowdy with Len Dawson, and Pittsburgh has a second and goal to go on the South Carolina 5-yard line. 28-14 South Carolina. They're undefeated. There goes Hayward, and Hayward is over for a touchdown. He lost the ball, but he'd already crossed the goal line. The freshman who runs hard. Ironhead Hayward runs it right over there. Good looking freshman, this guy.
Nothing fancy about that. A pitch out, as you're taking a look at the ground level shot, Hayward gets that football. Out front, there's number 79, Freilich. Also 46, the fullback. Stone is in there to provide a block, getting him into the end zone. Here's another angle you're taking a look at. See, the fullback takes off. Now, his job is to get around there, open up a hole, find somebody, and just throw your body. And there he does. He goes after the defensive back, Johnson. That's all that Haywood needed. Got into the end zone for a touchdown. Now we got a new ball game.
And while we did the rerun, they kicked the point. So the score is 28-21, South Carolina. We'll be right back. With power.
Yes, they did. And they're back in the ball game.
Good by on court to kick off. Yard return for him. South Carolina's ball on the 28-yard line.
We've got Mitchell back in the ball game. Number 11, Alan Mitchell, who started the game, the starting quarterback, is back. So I would have to assume, Kurt, that they want to go back to the Veer offense and establish something on the ground.
Well, we'll see. Thomas Dendy and Kent Haygood are the backs. Behind the starting quarterback, the junior Alan Mitchell of Batesburg, South Carolina. There's the Veer. That Mitchell keeps it. He faked to Haygood going through. He had a good fake on that. So he had the second option. The fake to Haygood was the first, and he kept it. And then if he didn't want to keep it, he could have pitched it out to Denton trailing the play for the third option.
One problem you've got here when you've had a quarterback on the bench for this long and come back, and you're handling the ball and faking, pitching it out, there's always a very strong possibility that a fumble could occur.
Keeps it again and falls forward to the 33-yard line. Well, he's carried the ball twice in a row. Benson and Walter Johnson, the left tackle, for the stop. This Benson's been on many tackles today. He's been all over this field for the University of Pittsburgh. Joe Morrison in the black, the head coach. Third down, 5 for South Carolina. Hillary and Wade are the wide men. Setting up the throw. There it is. Hey, great catch. Chris Wade, who has caught 2 touchdown passes. What a stab out of the sky he made on that one.
Really a good catch by Wade. Rolling out to his left, he has plenty of time to throw the football. That's the reason why this thing was so successful. But you can see Wade going up between 2 or 3 Pitt defenders, coming up with a catch and a big first down for South Carolina.
South Carolina on the Pittsburgh 43. Hillary and Bradshaw now the wide receiver. Wade's had 3 catches for 88 yards at a game. For Tom Dendy.
Pitch out to the left. He gets to the outside. You see a guard coming out, knocking out the cornerback. There, a tackle is missed. After that, it is a foot race, and Dendy is the faster man, getting in for the touchdown. Good blocking on the part of South Carolina.
Scott Hagler will try the point. Well, it looks like they got him bottled up, and bang, they break loose. Hagler's kick. Good again. 5 out of 5 in this game. 21 out of 21 in the season. Time out of the field. The score, South Carolina 35, Pittsburgh 21. We're going to be right back. This is the Cat Sports Network. And are all affected.
Good reason for that. It's pretty warm down on the field today, 80 or so degrees. Now, you always have fresh backs in the game when you get four good ones.
This is Scales coming out of the end zone. Scales. Back him down at the 15. He reached the 18 and then went backward. And the tackle's by Matt McCurman. Scales is caught nearly 100 yards in passes today. He's a dangerous player for the Pitt Panthers.
He's been the big play man. Made a big play last week, too, with a big catch. Four plays, 71 yards. Of course, the 43-yard run for the touchdown by Dendy was the big play. Good blocking on that play, too. Offensive lineman pulling out, making a good block on the cornerback.
Just when it looked like Pitt is going to catch up, they did catch up once. They were behind 14 to nothing and tied it. South Carolina gets a big play. Casper and Wallace, the wide receivers, in a slot left. Jelly. Coming through, Darnell Stone is hit by Gilliard. Let me tell you something. If Gilliard hadn't stopped him, he had a long way to go.
They're running to that right side. I was watching Freilich on that play, and he drove his man, I bet you, 12 yards downfield before he finally put him on the ground. Pretty good reason why they run to that right side.
Hit on their 22-yard line. Second down, four. 35-21, South Carolina leading. 12 and a half minutes remaining. Blattman has it. And the horse collar him around the 27. That's Ryan Gilliard, the free safety who came up to take him.
This is a draw play. Here you're seeing the back just waiting back there, letting the hole open up. There is a hole there. The official better get out of the way or he'll get run over. But it was enough for the first down.
Put it on the hit 28-yard line. First down in the I formation. Skip Minton down to a third string quarterback there.
That's a good play, a good pass play, but what the quarterback has to do, he has to throw it right on the letters so that once the receiver makes the reception, he has an opportunity to run with it and get some additional yardage. That way he had to jump up and make not a difficult catch, but he wasn't able to run with it after he caught the football.
Second down, six for the Pitt Panthers on their 32. Coming through is Bailey, Mark Bailey, quick hitter, first man through. He had the hole, and he has another first down for Pittsburgh. And Skip Minton again made the stop. Now Pittsburgh's on the 40-yard line in their own territory. They're behind by 14 with 11:15 remaining. Bill Wallace. And that's the fourth turnover against Pittsburgh, three against South Carolina.
Wallace was double covered. Coming down the field, you see he gets to the outside, but to the top right of your picture, that's another defensive man. He was being double covered. The pass was underthrown and was intercepted. Big break for South Carolina. We'll be back.
Oh, we'll be back here with a score 35-21 South Carolina. South Carolina on their own 47, a first down. Alan Mitchell again, the quarterback. That's Quentin Lewis. Lewis broke the tackle. Comes over the 50, 45, still going. He's on his way. And they pull him down. He nearly broke it. Elvin Dean, the quarterback, dropped him. He kept breaking tackles. He had a blocker ahead of him, and I thought he'd surely go, but They let that man get away from the blocker, and he tackled him inside the 10.
He didn't set it up. Bill Callahan, number 31, the strong safety, shoots through, and he has a first shot at him right here. Arm tackles won't get it. Now the speed is going to come to the front. Quint Lewis making a good move there. He has a blocker down in front. He really doesn't utilize that blocker that much. He just tries to outrun everybody. But Bell indeed made the touchdown-saving tackle. But regardless, there you are. Excellent field position right now, 6-yard line.
There he is, Quint Lewis.
We were just talking about the four backs. Dendy takes off 43-yard touchdown run just a couple of minutes ago. You got Quint Lewis.
Brown and Lewis are the running backs. This is Brown. Flag is down. He's piled his way to the 2-yard line, but we had a flag dropped on the way. Raynard Brown from Greensboro, North Carolina. Actually has a 5.2 average. This was against South Carolina.
I mentioned before the four running backs that we were talking about, they average 6.2 yards per carry.
Well, it's a luxury for a head coach to have four backs of equal ability.
If you have one, you should be happy, but here you have four of them that can do the job.
That's clipping against South Carolina. Puts the ball on the Pittsburgh 24 and makes it first and 24 to go for a touchdown. There are the penalties. Poole and Hillary are the wire. I'm waiting for him to go to this man coming at you. Hillary, he's their most dangerous receiver, number one. Maybe he's been a decoy today, and they let Chris Wade open for two touchdowns.
Here it is right now. You ask for it, you get it.
Put the ball behind him.
Trying to get a little hitch pass out there, but the ball was thrown poorly. What they want to do is get the ball out to him and get him one-on-one with a defensive back. Of course, we found out that Melvin Dean, number 28 for Pittsburgh, is a pretty good open field tackler.
Second down, 24 to go for a South Carolina touchdown. Chris Wade has replaced Ira Hillary. Wade's number two, and they're in a slot left. Bill Bradshaw's in there with Chris Wade. Fumble by Mitchell, and the ball's loose. I believe South Carolina recovered it.
They're still in field goal range right now.
Aldisert was in there to pile him up. Benson and Carter. So place the ball on the 24 of Pittsburgh, third and 24 for touchdown. South Carolina Gamecocks. 9:40 to go in this game. A 14-point lead for undefeated South Carolina. And a blitz on, and he goes down. And that's Dennis Atiyah. That wasn't a blitz. That was just a great... It was a blitz, but Atiyah, the middle guard, they call him, or the right tackle, he was in there. He is quick.
He certainly is. That's four or five really fine plays that he has made today. And what that does, I think, it puts him back for the kick. 39-49-yard field goal attempt.
He's two out of four. They say he doesn't have a long range. This will be a 49-yard attempt by Hagler. Scott Hagler. And the kick is up.
Almost. That thing sailed into the end zone. That was hit very, very well.
And Hagler being congratulated over there. He boomed that one. It is now with a timeout, 38-21, South Carolina. A crowd of 73,000 enjoying the home team lead. On the 15, and Stones brings it up to the 35-yard line. Chet Dix, reserve linebacker, made the stop for South Carolina.
See some of the frustrations of University of Pittsburgh players coming out right now. They need to score in a hurry. 8:40 remaining in this football game. Three touchdowns.
Chris Jellick's up now. Slot left formation. His right guard, maybe 3 yards, couple three. James Sumter, the left end, stopped him. There's Stone coming out.
They're alternating their fullbacks now, bringing the plays from the sideline.
Marlon McIntyre went into fullback. Second down, 7 for Pittsburgh. Gone down and then hooked back. He was open, but Jellick overthrew it, and he's a little disturbed at himself.
He had 2 men open on that play. Number 22, Scales, was also open in the flat, wide open, which would have given him enough for the first down.
We're down to 8 minutes remaining. 38-21, undefeated South Carolina. Unless Pittsburgh rallies, the Gamecocks will win their 5th in a row. Sumter. That's the trademark of the Fire Ants, as they call their defense, swarm and attack.
One thing we talked about prior to the game that was going to be a big factor, and that is the smaller defensive line in South Carolina could not let the larger Pittsburgh offensive line dominate the line of scrimmage, and Pittsburgh has definitely not done that today. South Carolina's played well defensively.
Fourth down. Jellick, this might be a time for a gamble here by Pittsburgh. Dunlap, the safety man. But he puts the low spiral away. This will be a return. Dunlap on the 20, 25, 30, 35. Still going and taken out by Pittsburgh's Keith Tinsley, number 20. 37-yard punt and a 20-yard return. That's always a dangerous punt, that low spiral. Your men aren't down there in time to cover it, and you get let that punt returner get time to gather momentum. Chris Major, defensive back, is down, number 13. South Carolina's ball on their own 41-yard line. And their job now is to protect a 17-point lead and keep an unbeaten season intact.
And they'll keep it on the ground. Alan Mitchell, number 11, the starting quarterback, is back in the football game. And I'm sure his purpose will be to run the veer, or at least run the football, keep it on the ground, and take care of some of that clock, 7:09 remaining in the football game.
There's Chris Major. He's noted to be the hardest hitting man in the secondary, Chris Major, and he got hit himself that time. Alan Mitchell, a quarterback. They've used 2 quarterbacks today. There's the last 5 possessions of South Carolina. They had a punt twice.
Last 3.
And 2 touchdowns and a field goal. They scored on their last 3 possessions. Alan Mitchell on the keeper to the 45-yard line of South Carolina. Brought down by Steve Apke and Chuck Williams. Second down, 6. Clock moving along. South Carolina naturally taking their time in the huddle.
Morrison's destroying that myth about bad guys always wear black, because he is really a nice individual.
They're in a slot left. Mitchell, keeper. First down. Tackle, reserve right tackle.
Take a look at that at ground level. There you are, right down in the shoes of Alan Mitchell, coming down the line of scrimmage. Now, what are you going to do? Give it to him? No. Are you going to pitch out? No. You find a little opening right there. Put that ball away, get upfield as far as you possibly can. That was a great shot there. Great shot. Number 57 is Carl Womble coming in to make a good block.
Lot left formation. First down, South Carolina, to Pittsburgh 47.
He's checking off now. could hear.
Clinton Lewis. Lewis at first down. Clinton Lewis had a couple of big runs in this game. Dante Wiley, the freshman safety man, had to stop him.
This is what the Beer offense is all about. Fullback blasting right in there. He's reading. He gives him the football because you did you see what happened to the quarterback? He really got popped after he handed off the football. He made the right decision on that play.
South Carolina's on to Pittsburgh 27. Quinton Lewis, the only senior in that backfield, those four running backs they have. The throw to Hillary, knocked down. Also, he had his tight end crossing over, Danny Smith.
Looked like Mark Rich got a hand on the football, number 93, I believe, got a hand on the football.
Bill Frelick, All-American tackle on the bench. It's disappointing in your senior year when you have a lot of expected of a team and here you won only one game.
Sure is. Particularly, I think, the way he has performed. He's performed very well.
Second down, 10 for South Carolina. Pitches to Lewis. Lewis dives over the 25 and to the 22 or 3 yard line. Chuck Williams made the stop on him.
Chuck Williams is coming hobbling off the field. Looks like an ankle problem. Trainer's going to have to go out and help him off the field. 86, Chuck Williams.
Mississippi has just moved ahead of Georgia, 12-10. Another roar, Wake Forest 14, North Carolina 3. Now we have the ball spotted at the Pittsburgh 23-yard line. And a third down is coming. Third and six. Look at the yardage.
Yeah, 400 to 261.
4:55 to play in this game. 38-21 South Carolina.
Oh, is he open?
Second touchdown pass.
He was so wide open. It was a good fake by Mitchell. And all Danny Smith did run straight down the field. He was wide, wide open. Here it is. Fake into the line of scrimmage. And there it is, all by himself. A linebacker, Aldersert, is trying to guard him man for man. Danny Smith is just a freshman. Second touchdown reception of the afternoon. Here it is. The most important thing is you got to protect your quarterback. And they're keeping them the face of the quarterback, an easy throw, an easy touchdown.
In the meantime, we had a melee in the middle of the field. Both benches emptied and went out there. The coaching staff had to come out and get them apart. There's a flag down. The touchdown counts. Let's listen. A foul on both teams after the touchdown. Touchdown counts, and there's been some hard feelings arising here in the second half.
Well, I think maybe the South Carolina recalls what you were talking about at the beginning of the show when Danny Marino was quarterback and threw six touchdown passes and put it on them pretty good. Some of these seniors were on the football team when that happened.
A kick by Hagler. Keeps his record perfect for the year. That's 6-6 in this game. 22 out of 22 for the season. And now South Carolina is roaring away. 45-21.
Big question was asked about this South Carolina team. Are they for real? The only really good team they played so far this year was Georgia. Well, they've put 45 points on the board against the University of Pittsburgh. I think that more or less answers that question.
Now, they're for real. They're quick.
Oh, they're quick.
Fired up. You get off to a good start.
They've had the advantage too. They played all their games here so far. Five home games in a row in front of 73 some odd thousand fans that are on their side.
You know, one of the reasons they play so many home games is the crowd here, a big gate receipt.
Oh yes.
Visitors like to get this swag out of here. South Carolina will kick it off. Tackles made by Jerry Dunlap. Next week, Pittsburgh will go to the Orange Bowl to take on Miami. Miami, by the way, is playing Cincinnati tonight. And so Pittsburgh comes right out of frying pan into a fire next week again, and see if they can rebound. Next Saturday, when Cats Force brings you the game on most of these stations, and it'll be a 12 o'clock start on the air from the Orange Bowl in Miami. 4:34 remaining. Hit on their 25. Gellick will have to put it up now. And it's dropped.
That's Gadsden. Gadsden,
yeah, he's from Frogmore, South Carolina. Coming back and playing in his home state.
Boy, that ball hit him right in the hands. He was open. Also, Wallace was open downfield because what South Carolina is going to do now, they're going to bend a little bit in that secondary. They're going to give them the short passes because what they don't want it to happen, with 4:30 remaining in this football game and a very comfortable lead, give them a quick, easy touchdown.
Second down, 10 for the Panthers. On the 40, first down, Pittsburgh. Earl Johnson stopped him there.
They came back with the same pattern because he was wide open the play before, and I'm sure the coaching staff saw that, so they called the same number. He was open, and Jellick did a good job of getting away from trouble back there and getting the ball to Wallace.
Scales comes into the Pitt lineup. This time spread to the right, Scales to the left.
A lot of confusion back there. Where they're supposed to be.
There's Scales open again. Over his head, they had him out there. He nearly had his second touchdown on a long pass in the game. He has the ability to get open.
He was wide open. He had Otis Morris, the cornerback, beaten by two or three steps. Gellick just overthrew him. You only get so many opportunities during the course of a game to get a shot like that. And that's where, you know, the winning quarterbacks are the ones that get the football to the men when they're open like that.
Second down. In the goal. Pittsburgh on their 40. Just under 4 minutes remaining. There's a draw play. Bailey hammered down on his 41-yard line by Gerald Davis, the second string left tackle. Number 53.
Made a good hit there because had he gotten by Davis, he had clear sailing. They're definitely looking for the pass. That was a draw play, and Davis did a good job of making the tackle.
Third down, 9 to go for Pittsburgh. From their own 40 and a half.
Is he throwing the ball to? I know that Scales was looking around to see who else was in that area. There wasn't anybody else in the area that happened to be wearing a white uniform.
Fazio says something, come on back. Gellick's in front for Mays. I would think they'd have to do something on this play. He's a quarterback. He's a punter. He can throw. Although South Carolina will be alert for him, probably. Gellick's had 7 punts and averaged 43.8 yards a kick. That's kicking. Well, he's going to punt it. Dunlap takes it on his 25, and they drag him down immediately inside his 25. So now we're 3:05 to go, and South Carolina looks like they're in and on their way to their fifth victory in a row. So we're going to be back here, 45-21 South Carolina. Travel arrangements made through Eastern Airlines. South Carolina's ball. Jim Desmond is going in at quarterback now. He's the third string quarterback. They have had Alan Mitchell start. Mike Holmes came in. He did a terrific job. And when he started to bog down, they put Mitchell back in. He did a great job. And Jim Desmond comes in. Jim Desmond.
We were trying to get a quarterback controversy started here, but I don't think we accomplished it because both the quarterbacks who played for South Carolina did a fine job.
Desmond, a junior from Miami, Florida. Getting straight ahead out to the 30-yard line. Zapke made the tackle.
They've got a lot of faces out there, a lot of bodies out there that didn't get an opportunity to play a great deal. We've got Anthony Smith, number 49, who was the ball carrier on the last play.
He's the third-string fullback. 2:40 to go in this game. South Carolina leading 45-21. Dunlap and Anthony Smith now. The third-string backs are in there. Desmond, the third-string quarterback. And that's Anthony Smith again.
This is how scores get run up because, you know, here Joe Morrison doesn't want to run the score up on Pittsburgh, but he's putting people in there that haven't had an opportunity to play. But when they get out there, they say, hey, give me the ball. I'm going to score. I don't care about running the score up because I want to get my hands on the ball and get into the end zone.
Yeah, I want to show you what I can do, Coach.
That's right, because I want to play next week, too.
First down, South Carolina on their 35. We're approaching 2 minutes to play. Anthony Smith once more, three times in a row Anthony Smith has carried it. He's a sophomore from Irwinton, Georgia. Every time South Carolina plays at South Bend next week against Notre Dame. First road game of the year. Their first five games have been at home. On second down, a fumble. Pittsburgh has it. They have the ball on the 44-yard line of South Carolina. He really fumbled that one. That popped up in the air.
That's Mark Rich, number 93. Here it is. They're just trying to run the clock out here. There was somebody who was stripped of the football, pops up there, 93. Mark Rich balls on the football, giving them great field position on the 45-yard line of South Carolina, but it's all but over. 1:32 remaining in this football game. Carolina, South Carolina enjoying a 45-21 lead right now.
On the 44, South Carolina. Pittsburgh has a first down. Flag is down. College pass incomplete. The flag dropped.
That was a good throw.
Yeah, that was Wayne Malloy, number 8. And a South Carolina man injured. Two of them on the same play. That's Rick Rebune and Earl Johnson.
He also
cornerback and a safety man.
Here it is, coming back in the pocket. He's firing that ball, and it really goes right through the hands of Malloy. Right here. Boom. Right through his arms. And there's the collision. 22 is Johnson, 21 is Raboon.
Lenny Johnson has been particularly impressive as a second stringer. He knocked down two third down passes. He had his receiver covered. He made a couple of key tackles.
Yep, see, he was a starter at one time. Now they have three players that are second teamers, more or less, that at some time, for one reason or another, started football games last year. You got Mitten is one, and Johnson is the other.
Rebune is up.
Rick Rebune. And Earl Johnson.
And Johnson's up. Well, Coach Fazio is in for another loss, it looks like.
Two weeks from today, they got Trump Hope, East Carolina.
They just announced 2 weeks from today. The two Carolinas go at it, South Carolina and North Carolina.
Kurt, 65 players played today in the ball game for South Carolina. So when Joe Morrison says we're going to use a lot of people, he was right.
That's complete to Scales. Scales down. Oh, had his head ripped off, and there may be a face mask.
Oh, yes.
Penalty. Scales has gone over 100 yards now in pass receiving. Shed Diggs pulled him down. Has three catches for 110 yards for Scales.
And he's been open a couple of other times, too. And they haven't gotten the ball to him.
There's the face mask. This will move the ball farther downfield for Pittsburgh with a minute and 20 seconds to go. So put the ball on the 24-yard line of South Carolina.
Face mask, defense, first down.
That was a 5-yard face mask. It wasn't a deliberate one. 45-21, South Carolina. South Carolina has equaled their best start ever, 5-0. They've done it twice before in 1902 and in 1928.
That's before my time.
A little bit. 56 years ago, the last time they did this. There's Scales, and he can't quite hold on. He was open again.
Yes, he was.
Now we have 57 seconds remaining.
Scales was open. Matt Stenton on the other side, he was open. He was holding his hands on his hips, standing in the end zone. He had a step or two on his man.
And we have another South Carolina man down. Executive producer was Fred Botwinick. This game has been produced by Jim Tillman, directed by Billy McCoy. Associate director is John Calabrese. Associate producer, Margaret Clarkson. Our stage manager, Rose Anderson. Broadcast associate, Mark Brown. Technical director, David Mazza. And our senior audio is Bob Dixon, the old master. Second down, 10 for Pittsburgh. 57 seconds to go.
Blitz was on once again.
Him there, out there, but
man-to-man coverage.
Mack Stennett, number 24.
There's another one. Thrown properly is a touchdown.
Jellick in relief now is 11 out of 23, 154 yards. He's delivered one touchdown pass to Scales, and he's had one interception. Don Jimmy, the starting quarterback, was injured early in the second period and has not returned. Is complete to the 10-yard line. Scales again. His fourth reception, and a flag is down with 46 seconds remaining.
Jellick is saying it's on South Carolina. Yes, it is.
We have a face mask on the defense. The penalty is declined. First down.
Pittsburgh declines the 5-yard face mask penalty.
Did you tell he was from the South, the way he talked?
Yeah, a little bit. They were talking to those cheerleaders yesterday, the South Carolina cheerleaders. If I had a butcher knife, I could have cut those Southern drawls into about 8 pieces. A piece, boy. Yes, sir. First and goal to go for Pittsburgh. 38 seconds remain in this game. Third stringer, Brian Edwards.
They had the blitz on. They were coming after him.
19 seconds to go.
Should have read.